I mean, the reality is that we're not going to completely shut down and just stay home and do nothing. You know, people want to live their dreams. They want to go on adventures. And knowing that, we have to figure out how can we do that in a more environmentally friendly way. Find out what our baseline is. Find out the footprint that we create, and then look at that and see where we can help to reduce that footprint. You know, traveling in a different way, using products over and over again rather than buying new stuff all the time, buying food and gear closer to the endpoint so it doesn't have to be transported. And ultimately, you know, you can't 100% eliminate that footprint, but learn then how to offset. It's not the total answer, but it is a bit of a solution. And so if we can educate people on that, and here's the ways that you can lessen your impact, I think those are the tools that people need, and then they can feel better about going on these adventures.
And you were surprised at the actual cost of the offsetting, weren't you?
It blew me away. I mean, we offset a group of nine of us going all the way to Antarctica, and it was less than $200 per person to do an expedition like that. I was blown away, and I thought, for that amount of money, it's a small price to pay in the scheme of an expedition that size.
Yeah. Another thing that you talked about, which I found fascinating, was climbing without oxygen, and you used it as a metaphor for doing a clean or cheating. And you weren't saying cheating in a bad way, but just saying you made the decision to climb without oxygen, and once you'd made that decision, that was the way you went. And it could almost be a metaphor for taking perhaps a road of sustainability versus taking a road of irresponsible consumption. And tell us a little bit about that, the whole idea that, you know, once you decide to do this, it doesn't become as hard anymore, it just is.
Right, you know, and I made the decision that this would be the way, the only way I was going to climb these mountains without the use of supplemental oxygen. And I made that a hard, fast rule. If you leave yourself some wiggle room, you know, when the going gets really tough, you choose the easy route. And I never wanted to do that. And I think if you have a conviction and you believe in what you're doing and how you're doing it, you feel better about it yourself. I mean, you're not trying to impress anybody. You're not trying to, you know, do it for any other sake than just feeling good about how you do it. And once you start down that road, you can see, yes, it is harder, but the rewards ultimately are greater.
Awesome. Describe for me how what you do as a professional climber ties into Source 44.
Well, I met and became friends with the co-founder, Jess Kraus, and I think what he brought me in for was, you know, I'm titled the Chief Inspirational Officer because I can talk about things, setting goals, doing things that are difficult, and help draw people into what we're doing to educate them. And also within the outdoor industry, who I know a lot of people there, and I'm also well known in that industry, they're very conscious about what they're doing and the manufacturing and the footprinting of their products. And so I hope to be a gateway for us to get into that industry to help them create products in a more environmentally friendly way.
Now, I understand this is your first time at the conference at Sustainable Brands.
Yeah.
Impressions? People that you've seen, people that you've met, are we moving in the right direction?
Yeah, I mean, I've been walking around and I was thinking about this morning, this is such an inspired group of people, and it's kind of the grassroots and kind of just the birth of this thing, and it's so great to be here right now to see how it's gonna just impact everything we do, impact how we think, and all the people that are here, they're so inspired by what they do. You know, it's this ball that's just gonna keep rolling and get bigger and bigger and bigger, and it's so cool to be a part of this right now.